everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Super Smash Bros. Melee playthrough. Last episode, we finally finished off Event Match with Level 51, the Showdown, which means Event Match is completely done. We can finally check this mode off the to-do list, which means we can finally turn our attention back to Regular Match and All-Star Mode, because we still have two characters left to showcase in this playthrough before we can say that we're done. And in this episode, we're going to take a look at our next character in line. So let's go into All-Star Mode and make our selection. So we are down to two characters left, ladies and gentlemen. We have Roy and Mr. Game & Watch. And for this episode, to finish off this weekend of Super Smash Bros. Melee action, we are going with Roy. And our difficulty level is going to be set to normal. So, without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Now, Roy hails from the Fire Emblem series, much like Roy, or rather Marth, I should say. Yeah, there are two Roys. Anyway, Roy is basically a clone of Marth. His moveset is very similar, but there are a few differences that separate the two. While we have the opportunity, let's talk about Roy's special moves. His special moves work very similarly to Marth, but there are differences. Roy's default special is the Flare Blade, which can be charged up. A fully charged Flare Blade can do up to 50% damage and send opponents flying. However, there is a drawback. There are two drawbacks. Roy's Flare Blade takes up to 5 seconds to fully charge, and when he unleashes a fully charged attack, he actually deals 10% damage to himself. He also has a side special. The side special is, let me check my notes, the Double Edge Dance, where you can actually deliver up to 4 hits instead of just 2, but I'm embarrassed to say this, I can't seem to pull off more than 2 hits with this attack. He also has his up special. His up special is the Blazer, much like the Dolphin Slash for Marth, and Marth and Roy both have the counter, but I think the timing is different for both of them. So that's the special moves for Roy, and now we're going to get back on track here, and we are facing Mewtwo to start off the next fight, so let's go ahead and clear him out. The thing about Roy is that another difference between Roy and Marth is how their attacks work. Their attacks work in a similar manner, like they can be executed in similar ways. However, one primary difference between Marth and Roy is that Marth's attacks do more damage with the tip of Marth's sword, while for Roy, his attacks do more damage with the body of the sword, which means Roy has to fight at a closer range than Marth. Whether that's a good thing or not depends on your preferences. But the thing about Roy is that Roy was actually one of my favorite characters in this game when I was younger. I actually liked Roy over Marth. I guess I liked Roy because of his attacks. His attacks are a little flashier and stuff. You know, because they have fire effects. But, looking back, it feels kind of odd that I kind of like Roy, because I was randomly looking at a Super Smash Bros. Wiki one day, and as it turns out, Roy apparently is not that good of a character. I was looking at it, I was reading this article about him, and it said, it actually said that Roy is 20th on the Super Smash Bros. Melee tier list. 20th out of 25, so apparently he's not that good of a character. Although I have a few things to say about tier lists myself. I don't want to turn this into a rant, but I might as well say something while I'm on the topic. I don't hate tier lists. I'm sure they have their place. I'm not gonna hate someone for adhering to a tier list or whatever, but at the same time, I really don't care what tier lists say, because honestly, if I like a character, I'm gonna use that character, and you know, if the tier list says he's not that good, well, I'm gonna use him anyway. It's like, I have fun with Roy. That's just the gist of it, really. That's the long and short of it. I like Roy, and I'll use him if I want to. But at the same time, someone wants to follow a tier list, go right ahead. I'm not gonna hate you for it. You have as much right to follow a tier list as I have the right to not follow it. Speaking of Marth and Roy, we got Marth right here in the Found the Dreams. So let's go ahead and take out our rival, so to speak. Although I think on the Super Smash Bros. Melee tier list, Marth is like number 3. Right behind Falco and Fox. So yeah. There's what I think of your tier list. Okay, now to move away from that topic. We are now in the 2-on-1 battle, so we're making some kind of progress as we face Bowser and Pichu on 4 side. Pretty interesting that they put Pichu here, because this stage is what happens. This stage does pop up when you fight Pichu. I wonder if it's a reference to the Saffron City stage in Smash 64, because that was a city stage, this is a city stage, so they put a Pokemon battle here. Because otherwise, it doesn't really make sense, because 4 side's in a completely different franchise, but this is a video game. I can't believe I'm talking about something not making sense. Since when have video games ever made sense? I mean, think about it. There's no reason for a game like this to exist other than an excuse for a bunch of Nintendo characters to fight each other just because. Like, there's no motivation, really, for why these guys would be fighting each other that I could really pick out, unless there's some hidden meaning that I don't know about. Now, the thing about Roy is that you're going to be relying on his side smash quite a bit. His side smash is a pretty powerful attack, and that is one thing I read in that wiki article, is that he does have to rely on that particular move quite a bit, so he's a bit... I don't know if one-dimensional is the best way to describe it, but there are times, there's a chance that his moveset can be somewhat limited as to what's practical. And like I said earlier, you know, he has the Flare Blade, which is a powerful strike when fully charged, but it takes a long time to charge it compared to other specials, and there's the fact that he hurts himself when he delivers a full power hit. And the thing is about hurting himself, he hurts himself regardless of whether or not you actually connect with the attack. So even if you miss, Flare Blade will deal 10 damage to Roy when full powered. So it's not the most practical move. And I think I'm gonna have to use a recovery heart here. My damage is getting rather high, and I'm approaching a big triple battle here. So I'm gonna play it safe. I'm gonna get the heart container. I still have 2. Hopefully I won't need to use the other 2. Hopefully I can make it to at least the last battle. And Ganondorf gets the Starman on a lucky bounce, and I am going to run away. Run away! How do they say it in Monty Python and the Holy Grail? Run away! It's the Black Beast of Ra! I think that's the line. It's been like 2 I haven't seen Monty Python and the Holy Grail in a long time. I think the first time I actually saw it was like 2 years ago. I never really was a Monty Python guy. That type of British humor, you know? Oh, jeez. Get back. I'm not getting blown up. You know, I might have to use the next heart container immediately, considering the damage I've taken in this fight. Come on. Dang, Luigi determined to not go down lightly. No. Screw you. I can't believe I'm having this trouble, man. I had that much trouble. Dang, dude. I mean, a couple slip-ups right there, and I easily could have lost in that round. And now... Okay, only got one left. But just three battles left. Let's see if we can do this. Although I'm not liking my chances, kind of, because guess who's in the fight? It is Falco, one of the top two characters of the roster, and he's already... I haven't even delivered a hit to him yet. And I'm already at 81%. I'm not liking my chances. And Falco goes down! I can't believe it, he could not make it back. You and that stone move, stone that! Freaking Kirby, take that. Well, I gotta use the heart container. Man, this has just been a rough final stretch. I mean, it's gotta be because of the increased difficulty, but even so, I'm really kind of getting I'm winning still, but it hasn't been easy these past few rounds. I mean, I'm telling you, these 3-on-1, these 1v3s really give you a hard time. All right, Link is out. Take that. And Mario's out. And the Ice Climbers are not too far behind. God willing. Oh, and he's shielded! Finally. Jeez. Once again, way too much damage, but... we are at the final one. 93% against Game & Watch. Let's see if we can do it. Although, if I have to use a continue at this point, so be it. I hope I don't have to, but if I have to, so be it. Yeah, you better chant for me. Come on, crowd, I need you to will me back into this. Use my up attack. I'm legitimately nervous right now. Okay, let's go. Three left. One left. Let's go. You and me. Oh my goodness. Alright. Oh man. That was a rough stretch those last few matches. I mean, had to use all those heart containers, but we made it. We still got it done. It was far from perfect, but nonetheless, a successful run, and there's another trophy, and ladies and gentlemen, we are down to one character left for this playthrough. So it won't be long before we're finally done with this playthrough. Very, very close to finally being done here. So that's another character down, one left.
Congratulations!
Roy Trophy, and that's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. We're done with this episode, but before we sign out, I'm going to give you folks a quick preview of what we're going to be covering next weekend. Next weekend, we're going to be moving over to the trainee mode. That video is probably going to be really, really short, but I am going to show off trainee mode just to show it off. And then the big one for next weekend, we're going to be taking a look at the versus mode, specifically melee and special melee. So look forward to that, and that's going to pretty much do it for this video. So, That's a wrap on this episode of the Super Smash Bros. Melee playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw, be sure to like and leave a comment and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Life Form RB signing out for now. I will see all of you next weekend for more Super Smash Bros. Melee action. See you then!